Hi, welcome to KV's Plants and Orchid. You are seeing my philodendron Congo Rojo. It is a native of South Africa. Today I'll give you the care details of this plant, how you can grow them. And it is in my care for more than 2 years. It's a very slow grower. When I bought it was very small, but now it has grown. In 2 years time it has grown this much. It is an attractive warm weather plant. It produces showy flowers, but for producing flowers it will take time. And it gets the name Rojo from its new leaves, which unfolds deep red. See the color of the new leaves, but later it changes the color. The old leaves are not red, see, it becomes somewhat like a burgundy green, not very deep green, so we can say it's a burgundy green color. It is a shade loving plant. It doesn't like scorching sun, so if you have to keep in semi partial area or where there is no direct sunlight. It is an indoor plant. If you are keeping nearby in your house, you can keep in a place where it gets indirect sunlight, not the direct sunlight nearby the window. It prefers a slightly acidic or to neutral soil, and the potting medium should be is such that the water should drain very easily. So here I have kept 50% cocoa peat and 30% server sand and 20% only garden soil, because my garden soil is very sticky, so I keep only very little for this most of the plant. So this plant has more of cocoa peat and sand, because cocoa peat keeps the moisture also. The plant is a humidity lover plant. If it has to grow nicely, you have to fertilize. You can use any liquid organic fertilizer once in 3 months, or at least twice in a year you should fertilize. Then only it will grow to it full size, and the colors also, the color and the color changing of pattern of this plant is the important thing. And one thing is, it is not a climber actually, like the other philodendrons. It grows somewhat like a philodendron Xanadu. I will show you. See, this is how it grows. So it is not a fast grower also. Then there can be pest attack like aphids and mealybugs, so you have to, when see this hole over here in the rainy season, snail attack. This is in my house, lot of snail attack in the rainy season, so that happened at that time. So if snail come, you have to remove, find out if you see them eating, you can remove physically. Otherwise you have to use any snail repellent for saving the plant. And don't prune this plant, because it is a very slow grower, so not like other plant, you don't need to prune them. So there is, and the propagation is, you in the big nurseries do tissue culture, or you can get this plant has produced a small offshoot. Can you see that small offshoot? You can remove that offshoot, that small plant, and you can grow. You can see, no? If an offshoot comes, you can remove it and you can plant it. Or you can, if when it grows really big, you can do air layering. These are the propagation methods. And the last thing is, this plant is toxic to pest and children, pest and human beings, because the leaves contain calcium oxalate, which is not good for us. So I'll see the plant like this. It's very beautiful plant. You can add this plant in your collection. Philodendron Congo Rojo. Philodendron Congo has many varieties. This is Philodendron Congo Rojo. Hope you like this video about Philodendron Congo Rojo. If you like the video, press the like button. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you are a first one to the channel.